Hey, and welcome to Growth Insights, episode number 8. I'm especially excited about this episode. We've tested tons of tools for you guys, and as usual, we're keeping the best for last. Now let's kick off with some tools. The team is extremely excited about the results we've been having on AdWords with ZenBids. ZenBid is the first robot artificial intelligence PPC optimizer and bid manager that actually delivers on its promise. Basically, it's a robot for your AdWords campaigns. It automatically optimizes our campaigns, flags irregularities, and even creates new ad groups when it feels it's necessary. This is legitimately groundbreaking stuff. It's saving us one day per week at the moment. Okay, and if for some obscure reason you still want to use human beings for your PPC and AdWords campaigns, whether that's employees or agencies, here's a cool little trick to see if they're actually doing any work. Click on this button in your account, see how many changes they've made to your campaign. You can then be the judge of how much effort they're putting into your campaigns. And now back to robots. Thanks to Esther for this Google Analytics artificial intelligence tool. Pave AI takes your Google Analytics report. It looks at 16 plus million possible combinations to identify the most important insights across marketing channels. And it gives you recommendations on which channels are working, which pages from your website are lagging, where to look for irregularities, to basically help you focus your attention better. It's free to test, so check it out. Still on the subject of analytics, but a little bit more advanced this time, if you have a mobile app, you should be really excited about this share from Quinton. On Radar lets you instantly start setting up geofences so you can adapt your messaging to people's actual location. Now imagine getting a message when a Tinder match is close by, getting a coupon when you're close to a Starbucks, or a game prompt when you're bored at the airport. Radar makes all of these possible with their geolocation SDK. Super simple to set up, check it out. Okay, now let's jump into content marketing. One of our favorite tools of all time is Buzzsumo. It allows you to see the most shared articles on the web for certain keywords. The idea being that if they're the most shared articles, we should probably be creating similar pieces of content. Well, they've just released a new feature called Question Analyzer. Type in a keyword or expression relevant to your business and see the most asked questions about this subject. Once again, this is a gold mine for content ideas and understanding blockers to purchase. Now, if you're the type of person to prefer cold emailing over content marketing to attract customers, we've been using a tool called Hunter.io for years now to guess email addresses based on LinkedIn account. The problem is the tool doesn't work anymore. Really sad, right? Wrong. No worries. The new kit on the block is snov.io. It'll allow you to extract email addresses from LinkedIn profiles or first name, last name, and domain name. It's free to use. Check it out. And another similar share from Quinton. This one's really black hat, so use it with caution. This allows you to scrape Google for LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, and Facebook accounts and look for email addresses that people leave based on their interests. Okay, so now you've got a ton of email addresses. What do you do next? If you want to check if those email addresses are valid before you run garbage through your SMTP, neverbounce.com allows you to test whether these emails are valid or not for super cheap. Thanks to Jim for sharing a similar tool called litmus.com, which makes sure emails are delivered and not in the spam box. It does an automatic spam test on all major email clients. Okay, so once you've got those nice clean email addresses and you want to send them out, thanks to Yob for sharing a tool from our good friend Sujan Patel. Mailshake is possibly the fastest and simplest way to design and launch a cold email campaign in minutes. Let's call it the MailChimp of cold email campaigns. So what do you actually put in those email campaigns? Quinton has been testing out a new tool called Quiller. We actually send out 100 to 200 PDF proposals per month. Quiller allows us to build delicious proposal docs and, more importantly, track what prospects look at and click. It's basically sales material on steroids. I really recommend you to check it out. Okay, we've been talking a lot about email marketing. If you think email marketing is dying off, thanks to Quinton for sharing botletter.com. As old channels such as email get saturated, it's time to look into new channels to re-engage customers and get them to actually open your messages. Botletter allows you to create newsletter campaigns within Facebook Messenger. This platform is still quite untapped and will give you a competitive advantage over the competition. They've also got a really nice and simple plugin which you can add to your site to get more subscribers to your Facebook Messenger. Okay, and on the same subject of Facebook Messenger messages, Yob got pretty excited because you can now integrate type forms directly into Facebook Messenger. For example, you can embed some of your quizzes or your questionnaires directly into Messenger. In Growth Insights, most of the tools that we share don't actually require a credit card to test out, but it turns out some of them do. And I know you don't want to put your credit card information in all these tools that you're going to test. So today we wanted to share this credit card generator. It's the one we use internally. It works on almost all websites and it'll create Visa or MasterCard fake credit card numbers so you can test tools that require credit card information. Okay, now for something completely different. Are you launching a new concept and you want to see if it's been tried before? Thanks to Stefan for sharing productgraveyard.com. It allows you to search through a vast catalog of dead startups. Or if your startup has just died, you can also write your own obituary. Thanks to Stefan for this one as well. We usually use ghostery.com to check out what kind of trackers and tools different websites are using because it's a really really simple Chrome extension. So here's a nice similar tool called whatruns.com. It also works as a Chrome extension. What sets this one apart is that the user interface is a bit easier to read and the results are loading super fast, faster than Ghostry. Check it out, it's free to use. Okay, and here's another useful tool for Facebook. This one was shared by Jim. Facebook Like Inviter allows you to invite everyone that reacted on your Facebook page to actually like your page. It's a nice form of Facebook marketing automation. Okay, now let's get a little bit serious with some powerful reading. This is probably one of the most useful articles that we've actually read in the past month. It's from the Boston Consulting Group, and at Growth Tribe, we've been training people and companies on machine learning for marketing and growth. This article correctly reflects our sentiments. 85% of executives believe AI will allow their companies to have a competitive advantage. However, only 30% say that their organizations actually have a strategy in place. We believe AI and machine learning is actually becoming the new growth hack that can allow small and big companies to have a competitive advantage. But you gotta jump on the boat now. According to the Boston Consulting Group, one of the biggest blockers to implementing AI within companies is actually education, understanding what AI means, what you can do with it. This is why we're starting a new series where we're gonna demystify all of the complicated AI terms and show you what you can do with AI for growth and marketing. Link is in the description below. Now, speaking of machine learning, let's look at natural language processing. A while back, Luke shared a really cool tool from IBM Watson. Thanks to IBM Watson's API, you can run rapid sentiment analysis on text. You can infer whether the person writing this text was pretty open, conscientiousness, an extrovert. Pretty powerful, take it for a spin. Okay, now let's talk a little bit about website optimization. Thanks to Luke for sharing Dareboost as the only free tool that he has found that does a comprehensive website speed and performance competitive analysis for two websites. So basically, you can take your competitors and see whose website is actually faster. The results are fast, easy to interpret, and share with team members using the PDF report download. Oh, and by the way, it's totally free. Okay, here's another one for our e-commerce friends. If you're currently running a Shopify store, check out Shopify Stash. It's got everything, an unlimited amount of resources for Shopify, from marketing to product pages, payments, stock, and delivery. Check it out. Really excited about this next one. Thanks to Bruno for sharing this really, really nice retargeting tip. We all know retargeting campaigns are one of the most effective ways of getting multiple touch points of leads. However, we all tend to put a pixel on all visitors who land on our website. Bruno recommends triggering the pixel only after the visitors has been on the site for 30 to 45 seconds. We're currently testing this and we're pretty excited about the results. There's a link to the JavaScript code in the description if you want to set this up on your page. And finally, we're not recommending a book this time. We're recommending a list of resources for user experience and service design. This was shared by Stefan. I've been reading this for the past 2 weeks and it's quite mind-blowing. It's called designbetter.co and it's a beautifully curated list of everything service design and user experience related. I really highly recommend it, especially if you're trying to create a great user experience for your customers.